Welcome to the course on co-creating sustainable cities. To introduce you to the course, I will answer four key questions. First, what is co-creation about? Co-creation is about making something new together. So co-creation is about action. As the concept refers to the actions that people and organizations undertake to make their cities more sustainable. Someone must start doing something, organize a meeting, develop a technology, start monitoring climate impact. But co-creation is also about interaction, as creating sustainable cities cannot be done by one stakeholder alone. Collaboration between citizens and other stakeholders, like companies or non-governmental organizations, is of key importance when working on metropolitan solutions to environmental problems. In this book, we use a lot of empirical examples to discuss with you what co-creation is about. And these examples come from all over the world. We show how citizens in Amsterdam put solar cells on their roofs and install home batteries to become part of a so-called virtual power plant. And we go into slum areas in Kampala to learn more about citizens and community-based organizations working together. They want to develop new infrastructures for sanitation instead of having to use the so-called pee-poo bags. And we visit China to see how Chinese citizens cope with the haze or the smog that has such a large impact on their everyday lives. The second question is, what exactly is being co-created? The title of the course says, Co-creating Sustainable Cities. Therefore, sustainable cities serve as our main objects, as the things to be co-created. In order to become more sustainable, cities require many solutions to all kinds of sustainability problems. And this is what AMS, the Amsterdam Institute for Advanced Metropolitan Solutions, is working upon. In the AMS Institute, the Dutch universities of Wageningen and Delft work together with the municipal authorities of Amsterdam, is MIT from the USA, and a network of companies and non-governmental organizations. And their aim is to develop sustainability solutions, not just for Amsterdam, but for cities around the world. And it is recognized that co-creation is at the heart of developing these solutions. In the course, we furthermore distinguish between two major aspects of co-creation in cities. First, you look at co-creating city politics for sustainability. For example, a new food or energy policy for the city. And second, we explore the co-creation of social technical systems, such as the energy system, the water system, or the food system. The third question is, who is doing the co-creating? And this course has a central focus on citizens who are doing the work of co-creating sustainable cities. Citizens are put center stage, as they are the people who inhabit cities and actively use urban infrastructures and services to organize their daily lives, to make possible their daily routines. But when co-creating, citizens interact and collaborate with other stakeholders, such as companies, non-governmental organizations, community-based organizations, and municipal authorities. And these interactions, they can run smoothly or be full of conflicts and tensions. They can be formal or informal, successful or unsuccessful. We will encounter many different situations around the world. Finally, the fourth question, that is, why is it important to study co-creation? Co-creation, we argue, is a crucially important topic to discuss, because urban sustainability transitions and innovations simply cannot do without. They always depend on and are influenced by co-creation processes of different stakeholders. So when city authorities, company managers, or future environmental engineers are not familiar with co-creation, they will probably be less effective in their work. To find effective solutions, it is important to know all about the extensive repertoire of co-creation that today is being practiced in cities around the world. And without co-creation, the much-needed solutions for metropolitan challenges in the fields of energy and air, water and wastewater, food and green, will not be found or implemented successfully, or at least solutions will be seriously delayed. With these four questions and answers, I gave you a brief introduction to what this course is about. I hope you see why co-creation is such a relevant topic for urban sustainability and that you want to join us in further exploring it. Enjoy the course and give us feedback on your findings.